And we're here on the eve of yet another Caribbean Cup final, second straight final for you and for this team. How are we shaping right now?
To be honest, I think the confidence is there. We've been doing pretty well in terms of getting the results. In terms of the performances, I think we have some areas that we could improve in, obviously, as a team. But I'm quite confident that can be successful in this final as long as we do the simple things well. I think there's no reason for us not to win this final.
You saw Jamaica yesterday against Haiti. A team that has grown in confidence. They've gotten better each game, and they're at home. Obviously, it means that this final will be a gripper.
But Jamaica versus Trinidad and Tobago is always an interesting one. I think it's the biggest rivalry in the Caribbean. Saying that you've seen the importance of playing a competition like this at home. We saw the first game Jamaica played in the tournament where they drew, and I think they've grown from strength to strength, and they've seen that with the numbers that have been attending their games, the support that they've been having. Playing at home is definitely an advantage for them. In saying that, I think we just need to buckle down as a team, as I said before, and ensure that we do the simple things well, because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter if there's 1 or 100 people in the stands. I think the important thing is what happens on the pitch. And as I said, I think we'll be okay.
There is pressure on the team. How will our players deal with that, handle that pressure for tomorrow?
This is the first time we've had our foreign-based players come back into the national setup for the Caribbean tournament. I think one of the things that develops very quickly in the players that play overseas is the mental aspect of the game, you know, being able to deal with pressure situations. Tomorrow will be no different. I think the likes of Kevin Molino, Kevin Jones, you know, Lester Peltier, these guys who play abroad, what they'll bring is that mental tenacity, that toughness. I really don't think the pressure should get to us tomorrow. I think once we stay compact, and you know, we really, as I said, can't say it enough, you know, do the simple things well. I think we should be okay.
What's the mood like in the camp? Final question. Obviously, there are some distractions, but the boys have been able to keep it together. What's it like now heading into a final?
For a lot of the guys, it's an opportunity to win something for the country, for the national team. It's been a constant progression for us since the appointment of Stephen Hart, who has been doing a tremendous job, as you can see. The mood is a very upbeat mood. I think everybody's looking forward to the final. Everybody's looking forward to playing and to winning something for the country, to get that respect, you know, that pride back to the country. We're quietly optimistic about the final. I think you see it by the way the guys walk about, the way they talk to each other, the way they move. Everything is about the final. Everything is about winning the final. What can we do to improve? What can we do to grow? What can we do to win the final? So, as I said, I think we're quietly optimistic about our chances.